The same temperature can feel different because humidity and wind change how fast your body gains or loses heat. Your body and brain adapt to what's normal where you live. And culture, clothing, and buildings set expectations. The same 60 degrees Fahrenheit that has people of Florida bundling up in winter coats might have people in Minnesota breaking out shorts. Let's start with the invisible factor that's probably affecting you right now, humidity. Humidity is the amount of water vapor in the air, and it's perhaps the single biggest reason identical temperatures feel dramatically different. When it's hot and humid, your body's cooling system essentially breaks down. Humans regulate temperature through sweating, where moisture evaporates from your skin and carries heat away. But when air is already saturated with water vapor, your sweat has nowhere to go. It just sits on your skin, leaving you feeling sticky and much hotter than the thermometer suggests. Humidity isn't just a summer villain. On cold, humid days, any moisture that touches your skin pulls heat away from your body much faster via conduction, as water is a significantly better conductor than air. This rapid heat loss is why a damp day in Seattle can feel bone-chilling compared to a 40-degree day in Denver. If humidity is the invisible thermostat, then wind is nature's heat thief. Wind doesn't actually change the temperature, but it absolutely changes how it feels. Your body naturally creates a thin layer of warm air around your skin. Think of it as your personal invisible blanket. Wind strips this protective layer away, exposing your skin directly to cold air. The faster the wind blows, the more quickly your body loses heat. Meteorologists call this wind chill, which measures perceived temperature based on actual air temperature combined with wind speed. But flip the season around, and that same wind becomes your best friend on a hot day, speeding up cooling by replacing warm air next to your skin and accelerating sweat evaporation. Now here's where things get really interesting. Your body doesn't just passively experience temperature, it actually changes based on where you live. Scientists call this acclimatization, your physiological adjustment to environmental conditions over time. People living in consistently cold climates develop better blood circulation to their extremities, more efficient shivering responses, and even metabolic changes to generate more internal heat. Research shows that Inuit populations have genetic variations that modify their fat distribution, providing better insulation for vital organs. Meanwhile, people in tropical regions show increased blood flow to their skin, facilitating heat dissipation through radiation, basically your body's ability to transfer heat energy away. This means if you've spent your entire life in Miami, your body simply hasn't developed the cold weather toolkit that someone from Minneapolis takes for granted. This explains why many Floridians get uncomfortable when temperatures drop to 40 degrees, while Northerners are celebrating t-shirt weather. But biology is only part of the story. Culture shapes our temperature comfort zone too. People living in different parts of the world have notably different ideas about what constitutes comfortable, shaped by both climate adaptation and lifestyle choices. Some countries maintain a constant 68 to 72 degrees Fahrenheit indoors year-round, while others adapt to the seasons, accepting warmer summers and cooler winters inside their homes and offices. When people from these different cultures meet, they experience the exact same temperature in completely different ways. What feels perfectly comfortable to one person can feel stifling or freezing to another. Your clothing choices play into this cultural equation too. Wicking fabric moves moisture off your skin through tiny channels, which helps during sweaty activity and heat. But in the cold, aggressive wicking can leave you chilled if you're not generating enough body heat. That's where insulation helps by holding a warm layer close. Natural fibers like wool can absorb water vapor and dry the thin layer of air between your skin and clothes, keeping you warmer without feeling soggy. Your perception of temperature also depends heavily on recent experience. Your brain doesn't evaluate temperature in absolute terms. It compares current conditions to recent memory. Spend a week in 90-degree heat, and suddenly 70 degrees feels downright chilly. Endure a month of freezing winter, and that first 50-degree spring day feels like paradise. So the next time friends in two cities argue about whether 68 degrees Fahrenheit is perfect or suffering, remember, they're each right for their air, their bodies, and their habits. And if the wind starts to mess with your comfortable temperature, tell the wind to chill. Just be careful if the wind takes it literally.